Since the launch of its first season back in October of 2010, it didn't take long for The Walking Dead to become the quintessential zombie series of the new generation. And now its 11th season has released, critics have opened up about the final run. So join us as we look at whether the latest installment is worth a watch. The lead up to season 11. When season 11 of The Walking Dead was announced last year, it goes without saying that fans were a bit overwhelmed. Not only were they just coming off of one of the strangest story arcs in the history of the franchise, they also had to put up with the fact that this season would be wrapping the series up as a whole. But since The Walking Dead has been criticized over the last few years for deviating too much from its original source material, this made sense. Didn't stop fans from feeling bittersweet about the arrival of the season though, which took place just a few days ago on August 22nd. But before then, AMC went on to release the highly anticipated trailer for the season along with the official synopsis of the show, which read, "Alexandria is severely compromised. It left a former shell of the home it once was from the carnage and devastation left behind by the Whisperers. Now all who live in Alexandria struggle to refortify it and feed its increasing number of residents, which include the survivors from the fall of the kingdom and the burning of Hilltop, along with Maggie and her new group, the Wardens. Meanwhile, unbeknownst to those as Alexandria, Eugene, Ezekiel, Yomiko, and Princess are still being held captive by mysterious soldiers who are members of a larger and unforthcoming group." From both the synopsis and trailer, something became pretty apparent. Season 11 was going to be the best season yet, showing a violent future where our favorite heroes would be facing off against not just a horde of zombies, but the mysterious enemies who currently have Ezekiel and the others trapped and tapped for information. The trailer also shows a massive switch in tone when it comes to the final season, with enemies of the past now having to be regarded as friends in an attempt for the Alexandrians to make it to the end. In other words, trust is going to be the name of the game when it comes to the upcoming installment of The Walking Dead. At least, that's what we all thought in the lead up to August 22nd. The question is, were we correct in our assumption? Well, now that a grand total of 3 episodes have been released, critics have finally begun to speak out about their thoughts on the final installment of the franchise, a critical review of season 11. And according to the critics, season 11 might not be as great as everyone expects it to be. While the latest installment has been well received so far, one point of criticism that has been repeated across the fan base has to do with the release schedule of the season. You see, the show announced that it would start off with a bang, bringing fans the answers they've been looking for in the form of a 2-part premiere. The only problem with this notion was the fact that the 2-parter was not going to be released at the same time. We know that this sounds a bit nitpicky, and to a large extent, we agree with you all that it is. But promising that fans would be brought a 2-parter, then having this premiere split across the weeks as usual, felt like a bit of a slap in the face. While one episode was something we could all be excited about, the fact that we were expecting 2 really put a damper on the mood. And don't get us wrong, we know why showrunner Angela Kang decided to do this. With only 24 episodes remaining, she wanted us to pay as much attention to each one as possible, something that's often missed when binging through 2 or 3 episodes at a time. But we weren't the only ones who felt hard done by this little misdirect. Eric Kane of Forbes wrote recently about how he felt exactly the same way, and that the 2-part premiere should have been precisely that. It wouldn't be the first time that a show decided to treat its audience like this, after all. Just recently, Rick and Morty released a 2-part season finale, which absolutely took the internet by storm. That said, this is just a small gripe that you would have only noticed if you were there from the start. If you haven't yet dug into season 11 of The Walking Dead, though, what type of experience should you be looking forward to? Well, since the first 2 episodes are named after the Archeon, a river of sadness from the realm of ancient Greek mythology, it goes without saying that some heartbreak awaits you. We won't give away anything that's considered to be a spoiler, but as the synopsis has suggested, Alexandria has most certainly seen better days. And since food levels are at an all-time low, our favorite heroes find themselves going after the Reapers with the intention of replenishing their stocks. Not exactly something we could have expected from them a few seasons ago, showing just how much things have changed. Critical consensus is that this episode was beyond brilliant, with special reference being made to the tunnel section, which really brought back the fear felt in earlier seasons of The Walking Walking Dead. Suffice to say, if you appreciate the tension built from clearing out old, abandoned buildings of enemies, you're in for a treat. There is also more than enough action to go around when it comes to this first episode. Daryl, especially, who is still being portrayed by the incredible Norman Reedus, is given one of the most impressive kills in the history of the franchise. But there is more to the Archeon arc than meets the eye. Accompanying Maggie and the rest of our heroes is Negan, who she is trying her hardest to forgive for the brutal murder of her love of her life, Glenn. It goes without saying, but the tension between these two characters is visceral, to say the least. Remember, Maggie wanted to kill him from the second he beat Glenn to death with Lucille, showing some massive character development when it comes to the pair working together. As we mentioned earlier, the concept of trust is an important one this season, and there's no doubt that the relationship between Maggie and Negan will be the basis for it all. So it goes without saying that The Walking Dead has not skimped out on the drama this time around. Has the show gone too far though with painting Negan as a redeemable character though? Some critics believe so, pointing to the fact that the show has written Maggie to be a cold-hearted character, with her verbal attacks against Negan somewhat causing the audience to feel sorry for him. That being said, that's the nature of The Walking Dead. It has always pushed the envelope as far as who's considered to be the good and bad of the world. And honestly, after the season 10 finale of the show, we're happy that Negan wasn't killed off in the past, as much as we loved Glenn. Another criticism that has come from the last couple of episodes is that the audience has been denied any answers to questions about the Commonwealth, who appears to be holding Ezekiel and the rest of the title characters. While these episodes were no doubt inserted to tease us once more about the workings of the Commonwealth, not much is learned. This has led fans to angrily write about how they've been waiting for answers for far too long. But we have to disagree with the majority here and put our trust in Angela Kang. The showrunner knows that she only has another 21 episodes to go to bring us the story that she wants to. And since this is the final season of the franchise, we truly believe that we will be getting some answers from the Commonwealth in the days to come. But the mysterious element still present when it comes to the workings of the group still keeps us on edge. And we like the fact that not everything appears to be as cut and dry as we once thought. Are they truly the bad guys of the show, or are they so good that they appear to be bad? This is just one of the questions we can't wait for the show to answer. But we don't expect these answers anytime soon. It must also be said that Princess, one of the best new characters in the history of The Walking Dead, has finally been given her own bonus episode, and it really is a treat. So if you're a fan of the crazy Puerto Rican, you'll definitely like what season 11 of the franchise has to offer. The biggest criticism yet. We've left the biggest criticism of season 11 for last though, which actually has very little to do with the running of the show. As we mentioned earlier, there is currently a spin-off in development which will be surrounding the lives of both Daryl and Carol, who will seemingly be continuing their adventure together when season 11 finally comes to an end. The criticism that this news has brought up is pretty obvious though, with many critics suggesting that this knowledge works against the final season and diffuses the tension when it comes to either Daryl or Carol being placed in a death-defying scenario. We know they're going to survive, after all, as they're joining one another in an upcoming spin-off. But Angela Kang has actually responded to this criticism, stating that fans shouldn't read too much into the spin-off that's awaiting Norman Reedus and Melissa McBride in the future. According to the showrunner, there are many ways to skin a cat, something we're sure Daryl knows a lot about. Rather than looking at the fact that the characters will survive, fans should be looking out for how they will be surviving, and in one state they will be when the finale finally comes to an end. Still though, it's not great for the running of season 11. What do you think about the critical response to the newest installment of The Walking Dead?